Hi friends, in the present video we are going to discuss about the role of pranayama with respect to metabolism. Friends, we have discussed earlier in part 2 of this series regarding the major factors which affects metabolic rate. In this part we will know how this pranayama regulate metabolic rate as per the bodily needs. Pranayama is a specific breathing practice for subtle body. It is called specific because it is a voluntary rhythmic process performed with conscious effort. It acts as an interface between gross and subtle body and also provides assistance to all the psychophysiological functions that occur in our body. Every pranayama affects metabolism in its own way. Here there are different types of pranayama in which some harmonizes metabolic rate, some increases metabolic rate, and some decreases metabolic rate. Sahit pranayama harmonizes metabolic rate. So this pranayama is a controlled breathing practice with specific breathing ratio of 1:4:2 for inhalation, retention and exhalation of breath respectively. It means breath holding will be 4 times and breath out will be 2 times longer than breath in. Retention of breath increases air pressure in lungs to expand its volume to use efficiently. During this time period, adequate amount of oxygen is transferred to the bodily cell rather than smaller amount used during superficial breathing. This provides opportunity for well-balanced metabolism within the cell. Fulfillment of cellular needs reduces excessive metabolic reactions and thereby minimizes formation of extra free radicals which damages the cell. By this way, Sahit pranayama harmonizes metabolic rate. Ujjayi pranayama harmonizes metabolic rate. It is a slow and deep breathing practice by focusing on slight contraction at the back of the throat. The exact area of contraction is subglottic larynx, which contains vocal cords and epiglottis. In general breathing process, all the inspired air does not respond to the oxygenated blood in the alveoli. 30% of the air remains in trachea and upper air passages as dead air, and it does not move to the alveoli for gaseous exchange during the breath cycle. By this practice, the exchange of gases across alveolar membrane increases and the rate of breath cycle decreases. Deep and intense concentration on breath tranquilizes the mind and induces inner calmness. Our vocal cords also helps to regulate the amount of air we breathe in and out. Due to slight contraction at the back of our throat, the rate of breathing cycle decreases. This sends a strong signal to releasing hormones synthesized within the hypothalamus, which are influenced by breathing. Trophic hormones are released from the anterior pituitary, which include thyrotrophin releasing hormone, which ultimately influences T3 and T4 levels, which maintain normal levels of metabolic activity in the body by secreting right amount of thyroid hormone. In this way, Ujjayi Pranayam harmonizes metabolic rate. Bhramari Pranayam harmonizes metabolic rate. It is a controlled breathing practice with soft humming bee sound through exhalation. This practice emphasizes on the sound vibrations received from the throat through the ear within the body. These sound waves are converted into electrical signals and then they are transmitted to the brain through auricular branch of vagus nerve. As the exhalation through humming bee sound is long, it vibrates the deep lying tissues and organs of the brain. Due to sound vibration, the electrical activity in the brain will be slightly decreased. This activates the major brain centers, which leads to significant increase in the levels of endorphins, norepinephrine, dopamine and serotonin, thereby it facilitates parasympathetic response, which induces relaxation to the whole body. In relaxed state, excess metabolic needs are reduced and the metabolic rate is regulated. In this way, Bhramari Pranayama harmonizes metabolic rate. This is a rapid, deep and forceful breathing practice. It is an active process which rejuvenates the major systems of the body. Rapid and deep inhalation and exhalation promotes proper blood flow of oxygenated blood to the cells where hydration occurs. This makes the blood cells far apart from each other and move freely in the whole body by carrying oxygen to the small capillaries as per need, which leads to alkalinity of blood. In this way, this practice balances the pH of blood and reduces the extra acid produced due to cellular breakdown or production of metabolic waste. As we all know, digestive juices are quite acidic. Our blood must be slightly alkaline, which is necessary for healthy maintenance of the body. Due to superficial breathing and excess fat, proper circulation is obstructed by the sluggish diaphragm, by which RBCs become distributed unevenly and fat is accumulated in spots instead of being burned up. This practice stimulates the abdominal organs and improves the functioning of diaphragm, which directly affects digestion and increases metabolism, which in turn transforms deposited fat into body fuel. In this way, this pranayama increases metabolic rate. Suryabhedi pranayama increases metabolic rate. In this practice, inhalation is done through right nostril by closing left and exhalation through left nostril by closing right nostril. So continuous inhalation through right nostril stimulates the nerve plexus in the mucus lining right nose, which is connected directly to the autonomic nervous system. So each cerebral hemisphere is connected closely to one or other branch of autonomic nervous system. The left hemisphere is being coupled to the sympathetic branch and the right to the parasympathetic branch. Due to parasympathetic dominance on the left nostril, blood vessels relaxes. Therefore, inhalation through only right nostril leads to increased blood flow associated with increased electrical activity in the left hemisphere of the brain, which results in increased sympathetic excitation. As different portions of hypothalamus regulate the blood flow in the two cerebral hemispheres, the dominant blood-rich hemisphere, that is here left hemisphere, controls all the sympathetic functions of the body. Thereby, metabolic rate increases, due to which body temperature also increases. In this way, Suryabhedi Pranayama increases metabolic rate. Sheetali Pranayama decreases metabolic rate. In this practice, inhalation is performed by rolling tongue and exhalation from nose. When air passes from rolled tongue, it goes to the lungs through the upper portions of the respiratory passages via pharynx, larynx and trachea. This induces cooling effect in the blood vessels of the respiratory passages, which sends neurogenic signals to hypothalamus to reduce the temperature of the body when it increases due to external heat. In this way, it facilitates internal harmony in the body by reducing excess body heat, which induces thermogenic effect on the digestive system, leading to controlling the hunger and thirst, which results in elevating digestive disorders like indigestion and gastric acidity. By this way, it reduces metabolic rate. Chandrabhedi Pranayama decreases metabolic rate. In this practice, inhalation is done through left nostril by closing right and exhalation to right nostril by closing left. So continuous inhalation through left nostril stimulates the nerve plexus in the mucus lining left nose, which is connected to the autonomic nervous system. Each cerebral hemisphere is also connected closely to one or other branch of autonomic nervous system. So the left hemisphere is being coupled to the sympathetic branch and the right to the parasympathetic branch. Due to parasympathetic dominance on the right nostril, blood vessels relaxes. Therefore, inhalation through only left nostril leads to increased blood flow associated with increased electrical activity in the right hemispheres of the brain, which results in parasympathetic excitation. As different portions of the hypothalamus regulate the blood flow in the two cerebral hemispheres, the dominant, the blood-rich hemisphere, here that is right hemisphere, controls all the parasympathetic functions of the body. Thereby, metabolic rate decreases, due to which body temperature also decreases. In this way, Chandrabhedi Pranayama decreases metabolic rate. Sitkari Pranayama decreases metabolic rate. It is performed by breathing slowly through the mouth by tightening the teeth. During this practice, along with air, a good bacteria called bifidobacterium, which exists in the mouth, also moves towards the stomach along with the saliva. It is one of the major bacteria that make up the colon flora, and it is also exists in the gastrointestinal tract and vagina. This practice enhances the quantity of good bacteria, that is bifidobacterium, in the gut, which resists various microbial infections in the gut and strengthens the immune system. Thereby, it reduces excessive metabolic reactions that occur in the large intestines and also reduces excessive heat from the reproductive and excretory organs, which increases efficiency of these excretory organs. In this way, Sitkari Pranayama decreases metabolic rate. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please subscribe to our channel for all updates. Do also remember to give your comments and also share this video for awareness about yoga.